Let us stand as we celebrate the life of Jerry this morning and open our hearts to the promise of God that life is forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Spirit be with you all. It was in baptism that Jerry became part of the church. It was a very important part of his life journey. We celebrate today the gift that he was to all of us as we bless him one final time with the baptismal water of new life. And as he was clothed in a garment of white on the day of his baptism, so we clothe him once again today. And as Molly places the crucifix upon him, let us rejoice in the death and resurrection of Jesus, who has won us new life. And let us all be seated as we listen to some words of tribute shared by Bob and Harry, good friends of Jerry.
Following Molly's instructions, I wrote this down and put periods in, since I am known to be a run-on speaker. We are here to celebrate Jerry's life. We will mourn his passing, however, we have to remember who he was. He was a man who had no quit in him. I once asked what drove him continually, and he replied, "To do any less would be to dishonor his brother's memory." Jerry had a good run and never dishonored the memory of his brother. I met Jerry 32 years ago, and we have been friends ever since that day. He was always a concise, to the point, speaker. Hence, I am going to do my best to honor that at Molly's request. Jerry is the only one I know that held an 8-minute meeting at the club. I never matched that. So, Jerry was chairman of the board for the club we enjoyed. He was long before I joined the club and probably will be in memory long after I have passed. He was our historian, our leader, and represented the heart and soul of the club. He will leave a big hole in the hearts of all of the members who knew him. Jerry checked on the club daily while taking his drive through the Point Beach Park. It was the route that conveniently passed Dairy Queen. I don't know if Molly is aware, but quite often there was a stop for a blizzard at the Dairy Queen. I joined him more than once. Jerry did love blizzards. I am sure if they don't have a club in heaven, there's one being started right now. And it will, if they do, it will soon be under new leadership. I am sure that you will find a Dairy Queen up there. Because supposedly there is no beer, so. But knowing Jerry, he did have a find a way of changing the rules. And I'm sure there may be a few beers up there for us to join him later. Rest real, Jerry. You're in good hands. The guy upstairs will take care of you, and I'm sure you'll serve him well, as you did here.
My name is Bob Bilkey. I'm here for Jerry and the family today because Jerry was one of my best friends. Jerry had three loves in his life: Molly, his faith, and the gun club. He worked tirelessly for all three of them. Many people can be replaced at the club. He was chairman of the board. Jerry can never be replaced. Someone will fill his shoes, but no way will they have the knowledge that he had of the club. You couldn't stump him on anything. If he didn't have the dancer immediately before the day was over, you would have it. So the first part of our relationship was rather skimpy. I worked a lot. And I retired overnight. I went skydiving without a parachute, and I broke many bones in my body. The skydiving was hunting, fell out of a tree stand. I'm here to talk about it, which is a good thing. You can't live on the past. But once I retired, and that was overnight, I had nothing to do. I did nothing but work. I can't sit. I got to do something. So I decided to go out to the club and work. And that's when Jerry and I really became friends. For the first month, I think I worked with him making weights, counterweights for our new doors that we were putting in. It expanded from there. And I got more involved. With trap, I shot trap with Jerry. He was always fun to be with. From there, Gene Morrill, for those of you that knew him, passed away, and I wound up taking care of the trap. Then I wound up on the board. Jerry was always there for me. No matter when I saw him, we always had time to talk. Getting difficult. His love for the gun club was only shadowed by his love for his Molly. He talked about her many times. We talked about our families and how lucky we were to have a very supportive wife. Molly supported him. She was always there for him. And likewise, he was always there for her. Jerry and Molly hunted and fished together a lot. They went out west, and they had their cabin up north that they went to. As Jerry got older, he was unable to hunt, but he always supported Molly. They went up to the cabin. He would sit in the cabin, and Molly would hunt. Fishing, they went fishing together all the time. When Jerry got limited to his mobility, he went to the assisted living. Molly lost her fishing partner. Molly and Jerry had many friends, both here and up north. One of her friends up north was taking her fishing all the time. His friends kind of objected to that. Why do you go fishing with Molly and not your friends up here? He had a very simple response. Molly knows how to catch fish. So that, his faith, I guess you can't speak much enough about it. He built a shrine to the Virgin Mary. He went all over Wisconsin and Michigan getting stones, put it all together, and had it lighted. You can't talk enough, as far as I'm concerned, about Jerry. Him and I were extremely close, and that's why I'm here today to talk about him. He was my friend. He will always be my friend. And obviously, all you people here are his friends. And I thank everyone for coming. Thank you.
Thanks, guys. Let us pray. O God, who have set a limit to this present life so as to open up an entry into eternity, we humbly beseech you that by the grace of your mercy, you may command the name of your servant Jerry to be inscribed in the book of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen. Let us be seated once again as we listen now to the Word of God. Debbie will share our first reading.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction, but they are in peace. For in the eyes of others, indeed, they be punished, yet in their hope, full of immortality, chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in God shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones. And God's care is with the elect. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Julia will now share our second reading.
A reading from St. Paul's letter to the Thessalonians. But we do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who are asleep, that you may not grieve as others do who have no hope. For since we believe that Jesus died and rose again, even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have fallen asleep. For this we declare to you by a word from the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord, will not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself will descend from heaven with a cry of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the sound of the trumpet of God, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will always be with the Lord. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus revealed himself to his disciples at the Sea of Tiberias in the following manner. Peter said to them, "I'm going out to fish." The others replied, "We will go with you." They set off and got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. Shortly after daybreak, Jesus was standing on the shore, but the disciples did not realize it was Jesus. He called out, "Have you caught anything?" They answered, "No." He said to them, "Cast your net over the right side of the boat, and you will find something." They did so, and they were unable to haul the net on board because of the great number of fish. When they came ashore, they saw a charcoal fire there with fish on it and bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish you have just caught." Simon Peter went on board and dragged the net ashore full of large fish, 153 of them. Even though there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus then said to them, "Come and have breakfast." And none of the disciples dared to ask, "Who are you?" because they knew that it was the Lord. Jesus then came forward, took the bread, and gave it to them, and likewise the fish. This was the third time that Jesus revealed himself to his disciples after his resurrection from the dead. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Like Peter, James, and John, and some of the others, Jerry was a great fisherman. And for those disciples to listen to the voice on the shore that said, throw your net over the right side of the boat, when they were the experts, didn't make a lot of sense, but they did it. And occasionally, Jerry would listen to someone named Molly, suggesting where to fish, how to fish, where to hunt, when to hunt, and so on. But most often, the voice that you and I listen to is the voice within. It's not voices that come from out there somewhere. It's that inner voice. It's what made Jerry a skilled hunter and a shrewd fisherman. It's what made him marry Molly, live simply, work hard, pray regularly. Now, lest we canonize him prematurely, sometimes he listened to a different voice within, and that maybe caused him to take a poor shot now and then, or to not listen to good advice from his wife or others, his good friends. But we recognize that, like the gospel, if we can listen to the voice of the Lord on the shore of our souls, we will be blessed, and our nets will be filled with love and gladness. Today, Jerry hauls that net ashore to heaven, and he empties it, and he says to the Lord, well, this is what I've collected in my time on the earth. This is what I've kept, and this is what I've taken along. And what might be in that net that he displays to God today? Well, there might be some family pictures, some fish stories, some worn-out rosaries, stone, perhaps, from the shrine in his yard, a book about Yellowstone, some t-shirt that says, from two rivers, proud to be from the east side. And God says, and nothing of Molly? And he says, oh yes, I brought my heart. Now, before this gets too sappy, the focus today really is not so much on Jerry, it's on us who are still fishing, who are still collecting things in our respective nets. What is in my net? We are invited to ask. Does it need some sorting out? Are there things in my net like grudges or excuses to not be the person I could be? Are there things like that that need to be thrown back and not carried ashore? Do I listen to the Lord's voice on my soul's shore? Or have I convinced myself that I know better? Even as I stand here this morning, the voice on the shore is saying to me, you've talked enough, you made your point. My voice says, But there's just one more thought I'd like to share. Lucky for you, I will listen to the voice on the shore. Let us turn then to our gracious God as Sherry leads us in our prayers of the faithful.
For the Holy Father's intentions, the national, local, and domestic church, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Jerry LaFond, as he enters into his heavenly rest, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For his wife, Molly, that she may always remember the fun moments with Jerry when she thinks of him, let us pray. For all of Jerry's family and friends, that they may support each other in grieving, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who suffer loss, especially the people of Ukraine, let us pray.
Lord, hear our prayer. Listen to these prayers, loving God, and all the prayers that are in our hearts. Continue to draw us into the mystery of your love, that we can be signs of your presence to all we meet. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Jerry, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your son to be a loving savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying. As one man he chose to die, so that in your sight we all might live forever. And so, in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy,
holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, profess your resurrection. Until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world. Bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Jerry, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. And let us wish that grace and goodness to those around us. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall.
Thank you. Oh, I just want to thank all of you for coming, Donna, the choir, the liturgy. Thank you. Father Dick, for coming. He was my boss at one time. We go back a long ways. I don't know what else to say except looking at all of you out there. I want to thank my family for coming from Ohio, my best friend from high school, Vicky, nieces and nephews, sister-in-law, my friends who went, Scott and Jackie. Scott goes fishing with me. He doesn't take me fishing. We go fishing together, and this is a story. I take the boat and run the boat. He thinks he's got the better deal because he just comes over, he's just down the lane, comes over and jumps in the car, and I have the boat all hitched up, and we go. I've got the better deal because when we catch 25 little fish, he cleans them. And then when Jackie and he want to have a fish fry, they call me over. And they say, do you want to come? Was that a question? What do you mean, do I want to come? So that's the real story. But missing Jerry, who is and was my best fishing partner, it's been a challenge. But having someone to go fishing with me, God provides. And this whole journey has been a blessing. Jerry is in heaven. And the one song, Take My Hand, Precious Lord, Jerry looked up in the room and I said, Jerry, is there someone right here with you? I said, is it your dad? His dad was right there with him. It's amazing. I said, your dad will take you to your mom, your two brothers, and your sister who just died on the 5th, on the 6th. Jerry died on the 11th. I said, you'll all be together. And he shook his head like, yes, I know. And the sooner the better. I can't wait. Talk about the communion of saints. So thank you so much. I am so blessed, and it's right here for all of us. Thank you.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body and blood, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Jerry may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Well, Jerry, you did it. You arranged a perfect fishing day for your funeral. Cloudy and drizzle. And the fish bite better on those days. So we thank you for that, to set the mood for all of us. But because it is a good fishing day, it's not the best day to be standing outside at the cemetery. So we will forego the procession to the cemetery and do the rite of committal in the gathering area immediately after our prayers here in church. Before we take leave of our friend, we recognize that there is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the word of God that has been proclaimed, in the memories that have been shared, and in the Eucharist that we have celebrated. We send him forth with the assurance of our prayers and of our promise to always heed the voice of the Lord that invites us to love more deeply.
Oh, God, be merciful, friend of God, as you take my love, and you bear
Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend the soul of Jerry, your servant. In the sight of this world, he is now dead. In your sight, he lives forever. Forgive any sins he may have committed through human weakness, and in your goodness, grant him everlasting rest. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. May the angels take you into paradise. May the martyrs come and escort you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.